Blessed is the man who puts his trust in the Lord. He will be like a tree planted by the waters, sinking its roots into the moist earth. He will have nothing to fear in time of drought. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This morning we have the first opportunity as a newly formed parish to celebrate the feast of St. Cuthbert, who is now one of our patrons, being the saint of Sussex. So it's a special day of celebration for our parish. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves now to take part in these sacred mysteries, we first humbly acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have poured out on your people the Spirit of truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd, leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord God, you kept St. Cuthbert faithful to Christ's pattern of poverty and humility. May his prayers help us to live in fidelity to our calling and bring us to the perfection you have shown us in your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. My son, be gentle in carrying out your business, and you will be better loved than a lavish giver. The greater you are, the more you should behave humbly, and then you will find favour with the Lord. For great though the power of the Lord is, he accepts the homage of the humble. Do not try to understand things that are too difficult for you, or try to discover what is beyond your powers. Concentrate on what has been assigned you. You have no need to worry over mysteries. Do not meddle with matters that are beyond you. What you have been taught already exceeds the scope of the human mind. For many have been misled by their own presumption, and wrong-headed opinions have warped their ideas. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Keep my soul in peace before you, O Lord.
Keep my soul in peace before you, O Lord.
O Lord, my heart is not proud, nor haughty in my eyes. I have not gone after things too great, nor marvels beyond me.
Keep my soul in peace before you, O Lord.
Truly, I have set my soul in silence and peace. A weaned child on its mother's breast, even so is my soul.
Keep my soul in peace before you, O Lord.
O Israel, hope in the Lord, both now and forever.
Keep my soul in peace before you, O Lord.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we shall come to him and make our home with him.
Alleluia.
Those who say to me, Lord, Lord, who will enter the kingdom of heaven. When the day comes, then he will say to me, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, cast out demons in your name, work many miracles in your name? Then I shall tell them to their faces, I have never known you. Away from me, you evil men. Therefore, everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a sensible man who built his house on rock. Rain came down, floods rose, and gales blew and hurled themselves against that house, and it did not fall. It was founded on rock. But everyone who listens to these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a stupid man who built his house on sand. Rain came down, floods rose, gales blew and struck that house, and it fell. And what a fall it had. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Shepherd, the builder of a church, a hermit living in Sussex in the end of the 7th, early 8th century. What has St. Cuthbert got to say to us living today? Perhaps far more than we might think. It is a call to simplicity. Western society, quality so badly needed with all our technological advances, our multi-forms of communication, our stress on political correctness, our double standards, on the one hand showing great tolerance in matters of morality, and on the other hand, our readiness to judge and to condemn. And the list could go on. And it's so easy for us, therefore, to get the wrong priorities. The life of St. Cuthbert is about putting God first, seeking his will, being obedient to him. It's about the importance of prayer, about caring for those closest to us, honouring our parents. And this is borne out in today's readings, the reading from Ecclesiasticus. My son, be gentle in carrying out your business. Concentrate on what has been assigned to you. The Lord accepts the homage of the humble. And our Lord himself reminding us, it's not about saying, Lord, Lord, it's about listening to these words of mine and acting on them. And blessed is the one who puts their trust in the Lord. Today we thank God for our new patron, St. Cuthbert. We pray that we will heed his message, that call to simplicity and humility. We turn now to our Heavenly Father with our many needs. Pray for our world, for a just, peaceful solution to the growing tensions in Ukraine. Lord, in your mercy, for world leaders, that they will heed Pope Francis' call, the call of the gospel, to unite in seeking the common good for all humanity. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who are called to the solitary life, that the Church will appreciate their vocation and will be blessed by their life of simplicity and prayer. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who ask for our prayers, for all the sick, for all those who struggle with anxiety and depression. And we continue to pray for the end of COVID-19. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
For Somu Amaladas, for whom this Mass is being offered, this being his first anniversary, and for Jerome and Galvin, Veneto and Jasper, that they will be strengthened and filled with peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And for all those who die young, and especially remember this time Philip Lloyd and Kieran Strudwick, and for their families, again, they'll find comfort and hope. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And we pause for a few moments to call to mind our personal intentions. Almighty God and loving Father, with great confidence we have placed our many needs before you. We pray that you will grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
All-powerful God, look upon the gifts we bring on this feast in honour of St. Cuthbert. May we who celebrate the mystery of the death of the Lord imitate the love we celebrate. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. for you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits you crown your own gifts. By their way of life you offer us an example. By communion with them you give us companionship. By their intercession show us support, so that, encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us, and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels, and with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Richard our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Solomon, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Cuthman and all the saints of Sussex, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Have the safest informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I will feed my sheep, says the Lord, and give them repose. Thank you. Let us pray. Lord, St. Cuthman worked tirelessly for the faith, spending his life in its service. With the power of this Eucharist, with the power this Eucharist gives, make your people strong in the same true faith, and help us to proclaim it everywhere by all we say and do. Grant this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I wish you a very good feast day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.